So let's try using some functions inside our code. If we take a look here, I've got that simple code we were doing in the explanations, where I've copy and pasted three lines of code. So I have display a first name, and then I'm printing a statement because I want to see how long my code is taking to run, and I want to check the timestamp at different points in my program. And then after this command completes, I also want to print out the current date and time. So this code runs just fine. And we'll execute that so I can show you the output that comes back. Python print time with repeated code. So when I run that code, you can see that it is successfully, and I'll just move this up so you can see the full output. So you can see it's displaying task completed, current date and time, and all the outputs. All right, but said, it's just I've copied and pasted code. So it's the same code over and over again. I can just take that code, move it up here, and add a function called printTime. Don't forget a colon at the end of your function definition, and that def means define the function called printTime. And just paste my code here. I do need to make sure that's indented over four spaces. All right, and now everywhere I was calling those three lines of code, I can simply call the printTime function. So here and down here. And I should see exactly the same output, except now I'm not copying and pasting code. So I've just added the function call now, and every time you call that function, these three lines of code will be executed. So we'll save that. We'll go down to our terminal here, rerun our code, and sure enough, you can see, let me just expand that again so you can see, once again, we're seeing exactly the same output displaying. So I'm seeing the task completed, then it's running through my loop and displaying the task completed and the current date time again. Now, this has the advantage. I should definitely go and add a comment here. This is a function to print current date and time. So I always want to make sure I add comments with my functions. Now, the nice thing about this is if I go, hey, wait a second, I learned a better way to call date time. I don't like this datetime.datetime.now. That always confuses programmers. So I'm going to improve the way I access that library. Said, and we're going to learn about libraries in an upcoming module. And then I can just say date time now. There. That's cleaner code, easier for somebody else to read. So once I learn a little more about Python, I can make my code better written. But I only have to change it in one place because now, of course, anytime I call the print time function, said it's already there. Now, what if I decide, hey, I want to display custom messages? So a different message depending on what task just completed. What I can also do is I can add parameters to print time. So I can say, hey, every time you call print time, you tell me which message you want displayed. Right now, it always displays the message task completed. So I might say, tell me the task name that you want displayed. And then every time that you do the print statement, it says, whatever task name you pass into me, that's the message I'm going to print on the screen. Now, if I do that, I have to make sure that every time I call the function, I give it a value. So this is printed first name. That's the task it just completed. And here, this is completed for loop. So when you put parameters on a function, you have to pass in values for it. We'll save that, and we'll run. And what we'll see this time is that the message varies each time it's called. So I see when it printed the first name, there's the call, my message that I requested, and the current date and time. Then my loop executes, and we call the print time function with the message completed the for loop and the date time. So that gives us more flexibility and more ways of using our function. So just because something's a little bit different, you might be able to use a function with parameters. Now, the other thing we do sometimes is we might have more complicated code. For example, I'm just going to bring up a piece of code here. Let's take a look at this getInitials program. So what this one does, and I'll just collapse this pane so we have focused on the code, is we ask somebody to enter again their first name, their middle name, and their last name, and from that, we extract the first letter from each name. So we take the first name that they enter, and we go to the character position 0, get the first letter. Then we do the same thing with the middle name and the last name, and from that, we can return their initials. So if I run that code, then you can see how that works. It's going to ask me to enter, oops, I forgot to enter the file extension. .py. My first name is Susan, middle name Jane, last name Iback. And it comes back and says my initials are SJI. So this code works fine, but again, I've got almost exactly the same logic happening over and over again. So there's another opportunity to be more efficient and readable in our code by using functions. So I'm going to go up here and I'm going to define a new function called getInitial. And when you call it, you pass in a name of some sort. And what I will do is I will get an initial back, and the initial equals whatever the name is you passed in, and go from character 0, which is the first letter, and retrieve one character. But what I'm going to do, it's a little different here, is in this case, I actually need to pass a value back to the person that called the function. So I say return the initial. There we go. So now I've returned the initial. So what I can do now is, everywhere I was trying to extract it, I can simply say, whenever I need an initial, call the getInitial function, and pass in the name whose initial I want to extract. So everywhere I was doing that logic, I replace with a function call. GetInitial, middle name. There we go. And here we go. This one here, we're going to change this to getInitial last name. Save that. And when I execute the code, should work exactly the same way. Enter my first name, middle name, last name, and comes back with the initials SJI. So what did I really gain from doing this? If you take a look at the code, I think it's a little more intuitive to see that calling getInitial makes it clear I'm retrieving an initial back. Up here, I should add some comment here. It says, this function will return the first initial of a name. But what's neat about this is I can do things like go, oh wait, I've had that problem with the initials returning in lowercase. If I need to fix that, then all I need to do is go to my function, make the fix in one place, say when we return initial, let's make that uppercase, and suddenly that code is fixed everywhere that I was calling it. So now, first name, middle name, last name, it doesn't matter, all of them return the initial in uppercase. So that's, to me, the real magic of functions. Makes the code a lot easier to maintain. Now, there are some other neat things we can do with parameters, and I'll show you that in the next module.